In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about spring joint 2D. So let's look at it with an example. The spring joint 2D makes a spring-like movement between two game objects. So here in this example, I have this box and this wooden plank. Now to this box, I have attached a rigidbody 2D and a box collider 2D. And also I have attached a jump script. The jump script will make this box jump when I press the space bar. I'll just show it. Now to this box game object, I'll add a spring joint 2D. Now automatically you can see a green line that has come onto this game object. It's currently connected to the camera. These are the properties of the spring joint 2D. Run this as default. You'll see that there's a spring-like movement that comes to this game object. When I press spacebar, it goes up and down and behaves just like a spring. Now the first property that I would like to explain here is the connected anchor property. The connected anchor is the point on the game object on which this game object is connected to. So currently this game object or the box is not connected to any game object. So we can set it to a point in space like I'll move the X values or Y values. So currently it's attached to a point in space. I'll run it once again. So you'll see it going up and down. Even with the spring motion, it's not going closer to this point. It's just maintaining a certain distance. If I zoom this up a little bit, you'll see a line here. This game object is trying to get till this line. It won't exceed that line. I zoom out again, I play it. So it's always trying to get to this line. Now if we want to modify this, we can't modify it with its default settings. We'll have to make some changes to this properties. So the first property I would like to discuss here is the auto configure distance. Currently the distance is automatically set. If you want to set the distance by yourself or manually, you can just untick this box and you can set the distance value. You'll see the line that follows when you change the value. So currently the way I have set is that the game object will reach this line. The next property I would like to discuss is the damping ratio. The damping ratio is the amount of spring-like movement that you want on this game object. The values range from 0 to 1. When this value is closer to 0, then you will get good spring movement, and when it's close to 1, you will get less spring movement. Let's start with 1. You'll see that this game object comes to a designated line rather quickly. There is no movement at all. That's because you have made the spring have less movement by setting it to 1. On the contrary, if I set the damping ratio to around 0.1, you will see that the amount of movement or spring movement on this game object increases, and it makes a lot of movement before reaching this line. Now the next property is the frequency. Frequency is the amount of frequency the spring oscillates before it reaches a designated distance. The value ranges from 1 to a 1 million. So the higher the value set, the more stiff this game object becomes. The lesser the value you set, the more oscillation you will get out of this game object. So currently it's set to 1. Let's increase to 10. You'll see that it becomes rather stiff. If I press the space bar, it has become very stiff. So I'll reset this value back to 1. Now the next property I'd like to discuss is the enable collision property. So when the enable collision property is ticked, this game object will collide with the other colliders in the scene. If it's not ticked, it won't collide with those colliders. So as an example, I'll enable this plank 2 component. This plank component only has a box collider 2D, it doesn't have a rigid body 2D. I'll run this. You can see that the box game object goes right through this plank. It does not collide with it. But when I enable the enable collision property, or when I tick the enable collision property and run, you will see that it collides with other colliders. Now there is a change in the behavior, and I'll explain that to you later on in this video. For now, I again disable this plank 2. Now the next property that I would like to discuss is the break force property. The break force is the amount of force which when applied to this game object makes it snap off from its attached game object or from the joint. So currently I run it. I do the jumping. I go right, left. The spring doesn't break. Let's suppose change this value to say 100. I'll reduce this value to say somewhere around 60. I'll jump on it. The spring does not break. So I'll change the break force to around 50. You'll see that the spring joint breaks. The break force is the amount of force which, when applied to the game object, makes it snap off from the spring joint. Now we look at the connected rigid body property. The connected rigid body is the rigid body with which this game object or the box is connected to. Currently it's not connected to anything, or it's a point in the space. So what I'll do is, I'll connect this wooden plank onto this box. Now this plank game object has a rigid body 2D attached. Its body type is kinematic and it has a box collider 2D attached to it. I'll drag and drop the plank game object onto the connected rigid body slot of the box. There you go. Now the connection is between the box and this wooden plank, and you can see that the anchor has been set here. Now there are two properties, anchor and the connected anchor. The anchor is this one, the one which does not have a blue dot inside. This anchor is in the local space of this game object or the box, and this is the point where the box is attached to. The connected anchor, that is this blue dot, is a point on the body of the connected rigid body. The connected anchor is a point on the connected game object. So if I make it to somewhere around 0 and 0, it's in the perfect center. So now we can say that the connection has been made between the box and the plank. I run it. You'll see that it gets closer to this wooden plank and then goes away. I'll jump. You will see that it does not collide with its attached game object. The reason is that you didn't enable the enable collision property. I'll tick this enable collision property and run this again. So here you can see that it collides with its attached game object. Auto configure connected. When this property is ticked, it'll automatically configure the connected anchor property. Then you won't have to set this connected anchor property values. But at the moment, you're manually setting the connected anchor property. Now I'll remove the enable collision property. I'll enable this plank too. I'll bring it to a little right on top. Now do you remember, guys, when I ran it before, this box did not collide with this collider. If you remember, this plank 2 only has a box collider attached to it. When I ran it before, this box did not collide with this plank or the collider. But at present, this box is already connected to a game object. Now we'll see its behavior. You will see that it collides with that collider. It won't collide with its connected rigid body, but it will definitely collide with the other colliders in the scene. So this is the change in the behavior that I was talking about before. When the box game object did not have any connected rigid body, it did not collide any other colliders when its enable collision property was not ticked. But when this box game object was connected to a wooden plank, it automatically started colliding with all those colliders even when its enable collision property was not ticked. So this is a slight change in the behavior. Now I'll disable the plank 2 again. I'll go to the box and tick the enable collision property and run it again. You will see that it collides with its connected rigid body. So this is all about the spring joint 2D. I hope you liked this tutorial.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.